Checking for potential electromechanical collision or clearance issues associated with a product is usually only performed in the mechanical domain. Left shifting the checking to also be performed in the electrical domain during the various phases of component placement can help ensure a more robust product. In order to check the PCB data in the context of the mechanical data within the ECAD domain, the ECAD designer must first import the mechanical assembly and then align the MCAD data with the PCB. Once the data is aligned, the 3D clearance rule or rules can be defined, and 3D design rule checks can be performed. To import the mechanical assembly, the 3D view is opened and the Import Assembly File function is selected. This function will import all mechanical data contained within the selected ASSY file. For this design, the assembly contains the top and bottom enclosure. Once the mechanical data is imported, it must be properly aligned with the PCB. Within the 3D view, the ECAD designer uses the mating function to select the alignment points for each object. In this case, a standoff on the bottom enclosure is selected, then the PCB is flipped so the bottom of the board can be selected. At this point, the bottom of the PCB is correctly oriented relative to the bottom enclosure. The board is then flipped back to the top side, and the standoff is again selected, followed by selection of the associated mounting hole. Now the bottom enclosure is aligned or mated with the PCB. The next step is to align or mate the top portion of the enclosure with the bottom enclosure. The ECAD designer again selects the mating function. This time an edge of the top enclosure is selected, followed by selection of the corresponding edge on the bottom enclosure. The MCAD and ECAD data are now aligned. The next step is to define the 3D clearance values. Within the 3D view, the ECAD designer selects the 3D clearance function in order to specify distances between objects. A global any-to-any setting is already defined with an optimal XY value and an optimal Z value. Clearance values can also be specified on a per-object basis. Here, J1 is selected, and as such appears in the drop-down list as an object that can be set to have a specific clearance to the assembly or various other object types. Any 3D clearance values specified are applied during both interactive DRC and batch DRC. The ECAD designer now moves component J1 towards the assembly. At the completion of the move, the assembly color changes to yellow and an interactive 3D DRC warning is displayed, indicating that the clearance from J1 to the assembly is now below the optimal value. The designer then continues to move J1 towards the assembly. At the completion of the second move, the assembly color changes to red and an interactive 3D DRC error is displayed, indicating that the clearance from J1 to the assembly is now below the minimum value. Any 3D DRC warnings and errors will also be conveyed to the designer during a 3D batch DRC of the full design. After 3D batch DRC is executed, the Hazard Explorer is opened and the 3D batch tab is selected. Notice that J1 is listed as a violation due to the clearance error to the top assembly. There are also other components listed as violations to the top and bottom assembly, indicating a potential need to review the clearance values with the mechanical engineer.